Hey, it's Wendy, and today I'm going to be showing you how I made a cardigan. It's actually going to be two cardigans, though. One is more basic, and the other is fancier. Since we're getting close to the holidays, I did end up making both of these in velvet. The first one is really basic to keep things nice and easy. It's got fitted shoulders, drapes down low, and I kept it long to give it a little bit more drama and not just make it the most standard cardigan. The second one, though, is not too much harder, but if you go for it, you're definitely going to get a bigger payoff in how it looks. It's a more kimono style, so it's got drapey sleeves, it's got pockets, duh, and it's got a silk accent going along the bottom edge and along the neckline. I designed the second one off of an Aritzia kimono that my friend owned. I'm wearing the original. She's wearing the one that we made out of that seafoam velvet. And yeah, I think it ended up looking pretty close. I was pretty pleased. As always, there is a step-by-step written breakdown in a blog post below for you. As well, I get a lot of questions about how to cut the fabric and what the dimensions are. That's also in the blog post. Sometimes the details are a bit dry and I don't like to put all of them in the video. If you're ready, we will go ahead with the cardigan. I used one of my existing sweaters to trace out all the pieces that a cardigan needs, one the largest being the one on the back, and then also two symmetrical pieces that go for the front two flaps. Then I also decided I'm gonna go with cuffs for the wrists, and then you need two sleeve pieces as well. First, I folded the back piece in half with the right sides touching and added one stitch along the spine, which gives it a bit more of a structured look. Next, use a straight stitch and attach the back piece to the two front pieces along the shoulders. Locate that shoulder seam that you just put in, and then also fold one of the sleeve pieces in half so that along the line of symmetry you can pin it in the middle and then go down along the two sides to attach the sleeve. Try not to pull and tug the fabric too much, and then once you're done pinning, you can sew the sleeve on along that shoulder line. Bring those two seams together at the armpit and sew down the two sides of the cardigan, as well as sealing off the sleeve. For the entire neckline and front opening of the cardigan, I hemmed it by doing a straight stitch and just folding it in a centimeter. Fold that bottom edge inward twice and sew that down with a straight stitch. The last step on this basic cardigan will be to fold those cuff pieces in half, then open up the seam and flip it so that it turns into a tube, and then we're going to attach this tube to the open end of the sleeve. Slide the cuff over the sleeve and pin it at an even distance all the way around by tugging on the fabric. If you use a zigzag stitch to seal all of that off, then your cardigan is done. On to our second cardigan slash kimono. Don't forget I put all the dimensions inside the blog. The back piece was essentially a very large rectangle and the front two pieces pretty rectangular as well. First sew along the shoulder lines, then you fold the sleeve in half, measure it to go across the sides, and sew on the sleeves. The pocket pieces are pinned onto the sides of the cardigan. You sew them on with a straight stitch, one on the left and right of the front and one on the left and right of the back. Now we are ready to seal off the sides by going all along the bottom of the sleeve, around the pocket, and down the side of the cardigan. With those pieces of silk that are meant for the bottom, fold them in half, line up all the raw edges with the bottom raw edges of the cardigan, and sew them together with a straight stitch. On those side slits, hem the seam open, and then also tuck in the silk twice and sew that down with a straight stitch. For that last piece of long skinny silk, we're going to sew the two loose ends together so that there's enough length to go all the way around the neck and the front. Fold that piece of silk in half and line it up with the middle of the cardigan so that you can pin all the way down the left and right. At the two bottom ends, leave about an inch and then fold that fabric inside out. We're going to use a straight stitch to seal that off so that when we flip it back, it's going to line up nicely with the bottom and be very clean. Just use a straight stitch all the way around that long skinny sash and you will have attached it to the neckline. Our very last step here will be to fold that sleeve inwards just about a centimeter and hem it with a straight stitch. If you liked how the cardigan or the kimono turned out, give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more of my tutorials every week. My favorite is getting tagged in photos when people actually make the tutorials. So if you do go for it or you just want to find me on Snapchat or Instagram, anything like that, I am at with Wendy. For example, this is a photo of a gray cape that someone made based off of my wool cape tutorial. I'm gonna be starting a basics series really soon. My goal is to put together a little video series that we can call like learn to sew over the holidays. And I'm gonna start from scratch, super basic stuff, but we're gonna work our way towards the machine and turn you into a pro. That will be all for this tutorial. I hope to see you all next week. Bye.